Kate Cuno says they spent the afternoon together on Friday, just hours before she disappeared.
The day of the party, I hung out with her. We made creme brulee. She was, I mean, everything was normal. I don't think she ran away or anything.
I mean, I would have noticed if something was slightly off.
So I was just like, okay, be safe. Don't, like, do anything stupid.
The only 10 minutes that I was there, I literally had a group of five guys try to come get me to take as many, like, bong rips as I could, like, forcefully without my boyfriend present.
A lot of older people started showing up that people didn't know. Like, a lot of drugs were involved, like, drugs that we don't typically have just in parties. And our parties also just aren't normally that big.
Says he complained about his day and she listened.
At 10:30, she responded to what I was saying and just said, oh, I'm sorry that you're going through that. And that was the last time I heard from her.
Yes, I was the last person to contact her after the party, and I was with her basically throughout the entire party.
No, it's okay.
Walking
it's
around
okay.
with her.
I know you got a lot going on. Was there a fight at the party?
Yeah, so there were some friendly fights that were going on. There was, like, we had boxing gloves. People were, like, trying to instigate. It wasn't anybody who had really any drama or... They weren't enemies or anything. It was more just friendly fights to keep entertainment going. This happens at a lot of our parties. We just do it to have fun. If somebody gets hurt, like, we have people on them. But
so it wasn't like a fight out of anger. It was just kind of a fun competition type of fighting.
Yeah, just see who wins and who goes home with the title. Which I will randomly admit, people do end up getting in fights over who won, but not this time.
At the night of the party, the last time you saw her. Can you tell us about, I guess, give us a rundown of the party real quick. I understand it was a large gathering.
Yeah, so it was supposed to be a senior farewell party where all the seniors and everybody from around our area, like Tahoe and Truckee and Incline and Kings Beach, were supposed to be there. They were invited there because it was supposed to be like saying goodbye to your favorite seniors before everybody starts going off to college, because soon enough here people are going to start leaving and moving out. And so Kylie's a senior, or she was like, she graduated early, so she's considered a senior, and I was a senior. So every senior was initially invited to the party. And as well, all grades were invited just to, so that it was, they could say goodbye. So I had talked with Kylie and I had known she was going beforehand. We hadn't planned on going together and we ended up not going together. She came with her best friend, Mags, Mags Larson. Magdalene, sorry, is her first name.
Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah, and so she came with her, drove in with her, and then Mags ended up leaving about 10 minutes into the party with her boyfriend, Ross, Mags's boyfriend, and told Kylie goodbye and everything, and they were never planning on, like, leaving together or staying together at the party. They just went to the party together because they were hanging out earlier in the day. And then I saw her the second she got there, and from that moment on, we were pretty much seen together all around the party. We would break off for mere moments from each other to go talk to other people or to go do other things, you know, but we would always come back to each other. We were just going around the party. We were drinking the same drinks, being teenagers, throwing glow sticks into the party, and it started to grow really big, I would say, around 10 to 10:30, just blew up. Like, it started to get to the point where I was getting overwhelmed, and I'm a very social person. I've been to a lot of these parties. I've never been overwhelmed. I've actually been underwhelmed, but this party, it was very large. Like, it was bigger than any party we've had in Truckee all year, and for a lot of years past. There were people from what we think Sacramento, San Francisco. I remember talking to somebody who was from San Francisco, Reno, Folsom, areas that were just way out of reach from it. And it was really overwhelming and weird to see, but I didn't really think much of it. I just thought, oh, kids are around here. They have vacation homes up here. They're just coming to party because why not? So then Kylie and I were going around taking shots and just drinking. We were trading drinks with each other. We were sharing drinks with each other. We would go back to her car to get some alcohol sometimes. And then we went to her car to charge her phone. And we were talking about just random stuff, and then it's kind of hard to remember. And so, or no, we were talking about her texting her mom and her charging her phone and stuff, and just about the party in general. And then we had a few other friends in the car, and then we all decided to go back to the party, and we were around in there for a bit. I had asked her for a ride home when we were in the car because my ride was leaving and I wanted to stay at the party longer. And so then we ended up splitting up in the party because I went to go find another ride when we got back into the party after leaving the car, so that we could sorry, my mind is in a moment.
No, that's okay.
I remember watching her have to take it off when we were using the restroom together. We were out using the outdoor restroom, if like popping squat basically. So yeah.
The very last text that I got from her was at 11:30, the night of the party, saying that she was planning on leaving in about 45 minutes and would be heading home. One of the reasons even that she had sent that text then is because we had originally planned and agreed upon a 12:30 curfew for the night. And so leaving at 12:15 would have put her home at about 12:45 instead. And she is so, so good at always reaching out and checking in, that she did that just to let me know that she was just planning on being 15 minutes late.
at about 12:36 a.m. in the morning, I saw a call from her, and she called me. I was on my way home from the party, and she was supposed to give me a ride home, but I had already told her I didn't need a ride home. And I answered it, and she said, "Hey, where are you? Like, do you still need a ride home?" And I was like, "No, I already told you this. Like, we're all good. Like, I'm in the car right now. Like, thank you so much." And she was like, "Yeah, of course. Love you. Good night. Like, I'll see you tomorrow." And I was like, "Okay, love you. See you tomorrow. I'll be safe." And then after that, nobody has had any contact or sighting of her. So.